In this video, I'm going to show you the raw to ProRes workflow to generate time-lapse with TLDF. Let's drag and drop a folder containing raw images. This time-lapse was taken in summer of 2016 at Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Current version of TLDF doesn't read Lightroom XMP files. When you drag and drop them, these files will be ignored. I have figured out a way to put the Flickr in the XMP files. Please let me know if you want this feature in the future update. While TLDF is generating the thumbnails, let's talk about the advantages of Draw to ProRes workflow. The first advantage is it generates true 10-bit or 12-bit video with the ProRes 422HQ or ProRes 4444. This is because TLDF sends the 16-bit image data from RAW files to the ProRes encoder. Sending 8-bit JPEG data doesn't generate true 10-bit video. The second advantage is ProRes video is great for editing and storing time-lapse. ProRes is great for post-processing because of its high bit depth with high bit rate. Because it is generated from 16-bit raw data, it removes the bending effect in the sky. ProRes files, though not small, are much smaller than 16-bit TIFF files. While keeping all RAW files, I store all time-lapse sequences in ProRes format as well for quick future access. The third advantage is the better deflicker result. Deflicker works best when it is the first step in your time-lapse workflow. You are free to apply edit to your sequence after this step. However, if you edit the images first, it may amplify flickers, which can make deflickering more difficult. Okay, thumbnails have been generated. This sequence was shot in aperture priority mode with f11 and ISO 100. As you can see, there are a lot of flickers in this sequence. There's obviously a photo that doesn't belong to this sequence. You can select it and hit delete key to remove it from the sequence. The raw file won't be deleted. Check the Flickr checkbox and hit preview to see the result of the Flickr. The result looks quite good. When you are happy with the result, click on the render button to output time-lapse to ProRes video. Most often, I choose ProRes 422HQ as the codec. For color space, I choose Rec 2020 to generate HDR video. If you prefer SDR video, you can choose Rec 709 as color space. This won't affect the bit depth. If you use RAW workflow, the bit depth is still 10-bit or more. Even if you chose Rec 2020, you can still generate SDR video by interpreting the color space to Rec 709 in your video editing software. For resolution, choose original size and hit Start button. It only took a little over 5 minutes to render 700 RAW files. Apple's M1 is very impressive. Let's watch before and after the flicker of this time-lapse in HDR.